A build that can speed boost faster than any other build. Shoot fades from half court while still being aggressive on defense and also driving to the basket decently. Not to mention getting a 93 ball handle, 98 mid-range, 95 three-pointer, 84 layup, and 82 steal. This build is unstoppable. What is good, YouTube? It's your boy Henry, aka HDF, and I'm back in the building with yet another bang. And in today's video, I got a build video for you guys. A lot of you guys have been asking what my playmaking shot creator build is. Now, if this video helps you out at all, make sure to drop a like on the video. I need you guys to let me know, do you want the DF Royales to come back? Because I will drop a DF Royale in Gold Rush to start NBA 2K21 strong if we get enough likes on this video. So drop a like on the video if you want that. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. 400,000 subscribers on the way. Come on, it's a click of a button. It doesn't cost you anything. Come on, show some support to your boy. But anyways, this build is insane. I've been streaming on this build. Once again, make sure you have notifications on so you get notified when I'm live on YouTube. I'm showing you guys gameplay in the background right now of this build. I'm going to show you exactly how to make this build, the badges I use, and the stats at 99. Now, this is like the fastest speed boosting build in the game. It's so fast. The ball handle is super high. It gets a 99 speed. It can spam the Curry slide without losing any energy. It can shoot fades all over the court. And it's actually really aggressive defensively. And I don't know why, but these play shot builds actually get decent defensive and driving stats, which just makes these builds so much more overpowered. And 2K has done 3 patches so far, and every patch they're just making these play shots more overpowered. They patched some speed boosting moves that made ISO worse. They haven't patched shot aiming. A lot of whites go in, especially at a high three-pointer or high mid-range. And even though they said they patched fades, fades are still super overpowered, especially on this build, which is making play shots better. The play shot statistically is just the best and most common build in the game because it's just so much easier to win with and so much more efficient than most builds in the game. The game is really revolving around this paint beast and play shot lineup. So I'm here to tell you the best way to make this playmaking shot creator. The other good thing about this build is you're gonna have a lot more people to play with because every center is an inside center most likely. And this play shot build can fit with inside centers. It can fit with shooting centers, any center build really, to be honest. And the build is also good at all overalls. You don't have to hit 99 overall in this build. This build is good at 90 overall. This build is good at 99, 95. I literally went on an 80 game win streak with this build at when it was a 90 overall. And I also won boot camp when it was a 75 overall. And we're gonna look at the stats later in this video, but there's really no disadvantages on the stats if you look at this player. Like, it's actually ridiculous how overpowered this build is. And even though I use this build, I think it's actually too overpowered. I don't know why the driving and defensive stats are so high while the ball handling and three-point are extremely high. Another thing is this build also gets the fastest jump shot speed in the game. So you're gonna be able to get a lot of quick shots off no matter what. As you can see by the gameplay, I'm very shifty with this build. You could do the speed boost glitch with this build. You could do the Curry slide. You could do spin bags. You can fade. You could really have a lot of play styles with this build. And if you want to know any of the dribble moves I use with this build, the link will be in the description to my dribble tutorial. And I also show all my signature styles in there. So go check that out. But anyways, let's get straight into how to make this build. Okay, so we are in the My Player Builder, and as all of you know, the play shot build is obviously the most overpowered build in the game so far, and the most common build in the game so far. But I'm gonna show you the best play shot build to make after all 3 patches. This is the exact build that I have been using, and hey, if you don't like this build, you don't have to use this build, but a lot of people have been asking me for my build because I have had a lot of success with this playmaking shot creator build so far in the little amount of time that I've used it. Now, if you have other playmaking shot creator builds that you created, let me know what you did differently in the comments below so you can share your feedback. But anyways, let's get into it. Obviously, I'm going to be going with point guard. Left or right-handed does not matter. I'm going to go left-handed. Because I just like shooting better with the left hand. And let's get into it. So the pie chart. Now, not a lot of people, but some people be going with this pie chart right here. It is not worth it. This pie chart is actually, in my opinion, one of the worst pie charts in the game, just because it's just not worth losing the ball control to barely getting any shooting. And some of the other stats are actually worse too on the defensive finishing side. So we're gonna go with the half yellow, half green pie chart right here. And then when it comes to the physicals, there's a lot of physicals to choose from, but we're a playmaking shot creator, bro. We're trying to create space. We're trying to get off quick shots And to do that, we need the most speed we can possibly get. So we're gonna go with the first physical pie chart, which is the speed pie chart. All right, so we are finally at the point where we are going to be upgrading our player, picking the badges and attributes. Now, there's a couple goals that you should have when you're upgrading your player when it comes to this point. Number one, attributes are always more important than shooting, so know that. So value attributes over badges. By the time I'm done upgrading, I want it to be where if I put like one stat down one, I lose a badge, and go up one, get a badge. So I'm at the max potential in each category, which is overall gonna maximize this player as much as possible when it comes to attributes and badges. So anyways, we're gonna start with shooting. Actually, you're gonna max the mid-range, max the three-pointer, and then when it comes to free throw or post fade, right, if we max both of these, I get 25 shooting badges. Do I need 25 shooting badges? Probably not. Could I save a lot of attributes? I probably could. So if we put down the post fade, we just put this down until we get the 23 badges. Right here is the minimum amount of attributes needed to get the 23 shooting badges. But as you can see, we have 306 attribute upgrades available. So let's see what happens if we put the free throw down. So if I max the post fade, put the free throw down until we have 306, we actually get one less shooting badge. So you may as well max the free throw and put this down to save a shooting badge. So that's done with the shooting. We get 23 shooting badges. That's plenty enough. Trust me, that is definitely good enough. Playmaking, we're going to max the pass accuracy. We're going to max the ball handle. That's very important, obviously, the ball handle stat. And we have 21 playmaking badges. Now, if we go down one, we go down to 20. So this is perfect because we don't really need post moves. And 21 playmaking badges is just good enough. Now, it comes to the defense. The most important things, perimeter defense, lateral quickness, steal. And then defense rebound because it gives you a lot of badge points. So as you can see, we have 6 defensive badges with 102 attributes left, and we haven't done anything on driving. So before I continue with defense, we're gonna go to driving because these are the most important defensive things. Now, no matter what I do here, I'm not gonna be able to get any driving badges. I already tested it out where even if I max standing dunk, driving layup, and close shot, I wouldn't even get a badge. I would have to max out post hook too just to get some badges, and then it finally jumps up to 8 finishing badges. But let's just see, what do we need in finishing? I think we need driving dunk and we need driving layup. Those are the most important things. Now, a lot of people, when they make their play shot build, they just don't upgrade driving dunk at all, or they do the opposite and don't upgrade driving layup at all. Trust me, I know you're not going to be driving a lot as a play shot, but having the ability to dunk and finish is going to be very important on these play shot builds. If you literally are running a play shot with a 30 driving dunk just because you wanted some extra defensive badges, trust me, that is not going to be good. It's just not worth it. So max the driving dunk, max the driving layup. We have 40 attributes remaining, and I'm going to put all this in defense because I already have what I want from driving. I'm not going to get any badges from that. Shooting 23 is enough, and I don't really need post fade. Playmaking 21 is enough, and I don't need anything in post moves. So let's look at defense. We have interior defense, block, and offensive rebound. Offensive rebound is probably the worst out of the three. Interior defense is actually really important to when people are driving, so I'm going to max out interior defense. Now we have 7 defensive badges. And now I'm going to put the rest into block. And as you can see, I still have 4 attributes remaining. So if I put this on offensive rebound, that can actually give me a 9th defensive badge right here. Now for me, I personally wouldn't do this, but this is how you can make the play shot build right here. You can go 1, 23, 21, and 9. But I did it a little differently. So trust me, there's nothing wrong with doing this right here. But instead of that, I'm going to go down on block until it goes down to 7 defensive badges. And when it does, I'm gonna put down the block until I have 8 defensive badges left. So this is the minimum amount of attribute upgrades I can use to still get 8 defensive badges. And I have 14 attributes left. Now, what I'm gonna do with these is actually I'm gonna upgrade my close shot. Because with play shots, a lot of bailout buckets are when you have no energy and you just run and fade on the corner. And that's technically a close shot. So I'm gonna take my close shot, especially for finishing around the rim and stuff, and put it to a 71. Now, once again, that's not going to give me any badges, but I personally would rather have the plus 14 close shot than the plus 1 defensive badge. So this is what I went with. Once again, you can just take away the close shot and upgrade the block and offensive rebound and get your 9th defensive badge. But this is what I'm going with for my play shot build. Now, when it comes to body shape, you can really pick any body shape. But I found that if you do the skinnier body shapes like slight, you just look way too skinny. So I went with solid because when I put down my weight, I'm not going to look too skinny and I'm not going to look too buff on the court. So I went with solid. Now, when it comes to height, a lot of people have different heights when it comes to play shots. Some people go 6'2", 6'3", 6'4", 6'5", 6'6". But trust me, bro, you don't want to go 6'6". That's too tall. And this is actually one of the first 2Ks where height and being taller is actually not a bigger advantage, especially since so many centers are actually 6'8", 6'9". So if I was 6'6", you know what I'm saying? I'm basically just as tall as a big man. But trust me, when it comes to play shots, you'd rather be fast, quick, be able to get off quick shots. Personally, I went with 6'2". Now, let me explain myself. I know you're probably thinking, wow, isn't that really short? But trust me, the best play shots in the world are also picking 6'2". And there's a couple reasons why. If you go below, anything below 6'4", you get the fastest jump shot speed there is. Now, I know there's no quick draw, and I know you can selectively pick your jump shot speed, but as you guys know, and maybe if you didn't know, height actually changes your jump shot speed. You can't have the same jump shot speed on a 7'3 player as you can on a 5'7 player, and there's certain limitations where 2K just automatically decreases the speed of jump shots no matter what because of your height, and 6'4 and under get that fastest jump shot speed in the game. So that's reason number one. Reason number two, if you go any taller, the ball handling is just starting to get too low for comfort. And the three-pointer starts to drop a lot too. 6'2", nothing in shooting is affected, but speed. If you look at speed and acceleration, that actually goes up +2, +1, and the ball handle goes up +1. And once you get to 99 or even just 95 on this 6'2 play shot, you are extremely fast and way faster than any other play shot in the game, and really anyone that's guarding you, and it's going to be a huge advantage. So trust me, being fast is way more important than being tall when it comes to these play shot builds. So go 6'2". Now when it comes to the weight, if you go 169 pounds, that's the perfect balance for the acceleration, because if you go up one, you lose acceleration. And if you go down minimum, you still have the same speed and acceleration. So just go 169 to get that +1 interior defense and that +1 strength. And then when it comes to wingspan, now this is another option I'm going to give you guys, just like I did with that one defensive back. Do not go max wings. There's literally no point, okay? Do not go max wingspan. You're completely destroying your shooting. And trust me, I know in the past I always talk about how wingspan is so important, but on a play shot, especially a 6'2 play shot, you're already short. That minimum wingspan or a shorter wingspan is not going to affect you as much as it would on a taller build. For example, Tysino makes a 6'3 shot creator every year. Every year he goes just about minimum wingspan. And he plays phenomenal defense because wingspan just isn't as important as it is for a taller player than it is for a 6'2", 6'3" guard. I wouldn't go more than 76.7 so you can get that +1 to ball handle. But for me, I'm going to go minimum wingspan, okay? Now at 99 overall, I'm going to have a 98 mid-range, a 95 three-pointer, and a 93 ball handle. That is absolutely absurd. That's like having a pure sharp with crazy dribble moves and 99 speed, because I'm going to have 99 speed at 99 as well. So anyways, go minimum wingspan, and now takeover. The only thing I would say is don't go with playmaking takeover, okay? Because playmaking takeover, number one, doesn't even work right now correctly. And number two, you're most likely going to be taking screens with this build, and playmaking takeover is more of an ISO takeover. Now, I went with sharpshooting takeover just because I feel like that is the best for me. You can also go with shot creating takeover if you feel like you're going to fade a lot more. But I like standing shots more anyways, and I've used sharp takeover a lot in the past, so I'm going to go with that takeover. And then as you can see, we created it. It gives us the regular play shot name, but that's fine compared to Damian Lillard, Stephen Curry, and Kemba Walker. That is great comparisons, I'm not gonna lie, especially for the modern day NBA. But anyways, let's go ahead and get to the badges. Right, so we're gonna look at the badges before we look at the 99 overall stats, because I am a 99 overall on this build. But anyways, let's get to the badges. Now when it comes to finishing, we only have one finishing badge. But with that finishing badge, I decided to go with Bronze Slithery Finisher, just because if I am gonna have to drive to the basket, I'm definitely, I don't know, I feel like Slithery Finisher definitely helps me avoid contact and get to the rim, and that's exactly what Slithery Finisher does. Some people would go with Contact Finisher, but I don't think I'm going to be making any contact layups with this build anyways. Now when it comes to shooting badges, we have 23 shooting badges. There's a lot to work with. Now I understand that there are very good shooting badges or decent ones like Flexible Release, Corner Specialist, Clutch Shooter, Catch and Shoot, and even Volume Shooter, Tireless Shooter, or Slippery Off Ball this year. But I'm going to be listing each shooting badge in order of most important to least important that I have on right now. The most important one is 100% Hall of Fame Rage Extender. You have to have this badge. This is the must badge to have on Hall of Fame. No questions asked. Then we have Hall of Fame Green Machine. If this is not on Hall of Fame, then you are trolling. This definitely needs to be maxed out 100%. Then I would say Hot Zone Hunter on Hall of Fame, just because you're probably going to have most of your hot zones on a play shot anyways, considering it's a very good shooting build. So Hall of Fame Hot Zone Hunter is going to basically work in every single spot that you shoot. Then I'm going to go with the most underrated badge in the game, and I think that is Hot Start. If you make your first shot or green your first shot, it is over with the combination of Hot Start and Green Machine, because this badge goes crazy. Every time I green my first shot, it's like I can't miss after that. This badge is very overpowered. I have it on gold. And then the next two is Difficult and Deadeye. I have both those on Hall of Fame. Difficult was very good in patch 1 and patch 2, but after patch 3, fading is going to be worse and worse, but I'm still going to be using it on Hall of Fame because I am very good with fading, especially with Tego, where I feel like Hall of Fame Difficult Shots is definitely the badge to have on, especially in this game with how OP fading really is. And then Deadeye, of course, because I like to quick stop a lot and I like to get fast shots off, and after doing a lot of dribble moves, and to have Deadeye on is very important if I want to do that. Now with a play shot, you're only going to be open for a couple seconds sometimes, so being the best play shot you could be, the best play shots in the game are going to take those shots when they have them, even if it's just a split second. Hall of Fame Deadeye is going to help you a lot when it comes to greening shots that are only open for a second or two. Anyways, going on to the playmaking badges, we have 21 playmaking badges. There's a lot of combinations you could do, but Unpluckable, Stop and Go, First Step, and Handles for Days have to be Hall of Fame. I don't think there is any questions. You must use, those are the four most important badges here. Now, I also use Bronze Bailout. I don't think you need it on any higher. The only reason I say that is because when I make out bail, when I pass out on my shots, they always go through and I only have Bronze Bailout on. Then I put on Tight Handles on Bronze just because it doesn't really work as much this year, or it's not really effective, as I should say, so I only put it on Bronze. And then I just threw on Needle Threader on Gold. You could really throw this on anything. Maybe you want to do Floor General or Dimer, but I run with the inside center, so I don't really need that. I don't run Lob City Passer. I don't think it's needed with a high pass accuracy. Space Critter isn't really needed. Ankle Breaker doesn't work yet. You could even run Flashy Passer if you want to, but right now I'm running Needle Threader just so I get my lobs and my passes to my center's cuts a lot faster. Anyways, going to the defensive badges, I don't have my defensive badges maxed, but here's the four I'm using right now. I'm using Gold Clamps and Bronze Intimidator. If I had the extra four, I'd probably use Gold Clamps and Gold Intimidator, and then put the rest on either Silver Pick Dodge or Silver Pickpocket. That's enough for the badges. Let's go on to the attributes at 99 overall. So here are my stats right here. This is absolutely insane, bro. If you look across these stats, there really is nothing the play shot can't do. We have a 99 speed, a 98 acceleration, a 72 vertical, 99 stamina. If you look at the driving, this is its worst category, but it still gets an 84 driving layup, and I still get dunked just about every single time I'm open for one. A 66 driving dunk is perfect for that. Then when we get to the shooting, this is literally like pure sharp stats. A 95 three-pointer? That is absurd in a 98 mid-range. That is literally ridiculous. And then ball handling, I have a 93 ball handle and a 92 pass accuracy, which is very good. That's why I really only need to use bailout on bronze. And having a 93 ball handle, I am super fast with my dribble moves, and dribbling is just so much easier with a higher ball handle. But anyways, when we get to the defense, 78 perimeter defense, 78 lateral quickness, 82 steal. These are great stats right here for a playmaking shocker. And to be honest, I don't know why they're giving these good of attributes when it comes to the defensive side to a play shot. Like, these play shot builds are honestly too overpowered in my opinion. Their driving layup and some of their defensive stats right here just shouldn't be this high, but they are. 66 defense rebound, 47 interior defense. This play shot can really do it all, I'm not gonna lie. And on top of that, for me, I also have the Gym Rat badge that you get at Superstar 2. You can also get that badge by winning the NBA Finals in my career. So I have +4 to all of my physical attributes, and I won boot camp, so I have unlimited boost, making this build absolutely ridiculous. Anyways, guys, I hope this video helped you guys out at all, and if it did, make sure to drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if you're new, Turn on a notification so you can see every time I go live on YouTube. Sometimes I ISO with my slasher or I take screens with my play shot right here. Once again, make sure to badge out this player, get your hotspots, learn those dribble moves, and you'll be good to go. It's been your boy Henry, aka HDF, and I'm out, y'all.